All right, so welcome back, everybody. We are back here. We've got the second map for the day going on, and there we go. FUBAR ready, HSG ready. So, money, why don't you give them 150, 155-0 as start time there. We'll do the
By the time I'm done
go.
typing that, it'll be ready. How about 154?
All right, 154. We'll give it a minute and a half there. All right, so we will be following FUBAR around for my camera on this map here. Again, playing OP first light down to 100
Intro call
tickets,
going
so a
very well.
200 ticket match here.
Oh my God, Brent, please.
And HSG
Oh my God,
pulled
just
off the
talking
first
here.
round.
Smokes, yeah.
Yep.
They won at 169 to 100, so by 69 tickets. And also, we'd like to take a brief second to, from a squad lead perspective, go ahead and thank everybody that has donated in the past. Duffy that donated today. You know, we've had some really big donators throughout the past, and we just want to say we really appreciate it, guys. That you know, donations are what allow us to quote keep the lights on and allow us to keep running these servers and everything like that. So you know, we run a European server right now, and we have this one that's based out of New York City. And your donations go a long way toward allowing Squad League to continue doing what it is that we do. So you know, depending on how well we do through the tournament, we might have to, you know, turn off the European server for a bit. So just, you know, we really appreciate it, and we definitely hope that everyone is all right with that. So here we go.
There we go. Okay, so following FUBAR, it's gonna be interesting how they play against HSG from this other side of the map. I know every team
It
has a different tactic.
looks as if they're doing the same thing.
The delayed spawning.
Yeah.
Yep. They've got two, four. They've only got seven guys spawned in right now. Is that it?
There they
Nope,
go.
they just dropped a they dropped a fob and then all spawned in on that.
So that you can see that huge pack of guys there running out to storage.
So Blitza and Doc East, they just dropped that fob on the way to Nilrim. You think they put something down like that to get some logistics going as far as like ammo crates to support a little bit closer to the battle there, or what you're thinking on that?
You said they placed them.
Go on, Doc.
No, go, Ben.
I can't actually see
Nope,
it.
they took it down. They took
Yeah,
it down.
yeah. And as I say, I don't see a fob.
Yeah, it's very strange. Like I said on the first round, I've never seen anything like that before. I don't know whether it's to give him a bit of a boost sprint-wise, spawn in and straight on the sprint instead of running out 80% of the way. I'm not sure.
But even that, it just the stamina is kind of trivial. I don't think it's worth. I mean, I don't know. Another
Either
team's
way, they're all
before,
in now. Here they
same with
go.
Blitzer.
I think the time it takes to then remove the fob after it's put up would be basically it negates whatever you've just achieved.
Exactly.
But
Well,
oh
so
well.
you're about to get some contact down that center vein.
Yep,
You got
right
Mr.
above end game.
Shaggy in game, and you've got some HSG coming down. So there definitely going to be some engagement center map here very shortly.
Yep, that's that center lane, man.
So first one, HSG goes down.
First shot, Jackie kills no.
Yep.
New, how do you say his name? First blood.
All right, so HSG is getting to the east side of storage first. They're getting inside that building. Looks like they're bringing another squad on the west side to start covering on the sides there. I don't know if they're going to drop a fob out there, Blitza, to support that. Might be worth something keeping an eye on.
Yeah, looks like squad 2 are pushing out for a position for fob, like you said.
FUBAR coming in from the southwest, dropping in rockets inside that building, so they're definitely trying to start working their way in there as well.
Looks like HSG has a quick hold on storage as well. You see, you got they got three guys in there right now, so they should be capping it. That's neutral anyway, so they should be capping it with one. But well, they will be as soon as they cap storage. That's also another good play.
Well, Fubar's about to run on that west side. Go ahead.
Right, it's a good play. You know, you want to. It's always a good play. You always want to be fast and aggressive. It comes down to speed majority of the time, especially off the break. You know, leaving one guy to cap storage, even if you haven't capped storage or storage. I'm sorry, even if you haven't capped castle yet, leaving one guy there while everybody else gets in the cap on storage is the foot in the door you need. The moment Jericho back there caps castle, storage will be flipping.
How close?
Right by my body. Right by my body.
But judging from the amount of personnel that Fubar has south there, might not be able to get one.
Yeah, they're calling out commander comms, enemies west of storage. So, I mean, obviously, from all the gunfire, they should know. But definitely put it out in the commander comms of where they're taking contact.
Yeah, HSG just over the comms saying that they are capping storage, which is obvious with the four bodies they've gotten.
Right. This is where Fubar, it looks like some of the guys are pushing in now, but this is where, you know, especially playing against these clans, they know that the sooner you cap these objectives, the sooner you win the game. So Fubar should know right now to get guys inside of storage, even if just as many people as you can, just to stop their cap, whatever it takes. Once they just capped the castle, they know they're going to be trying to flip storage.
Yep, they're coming in now.
Cap stuff.
I'm in west side right now.
Where are you at right now, Rusty?
Sorry, I'm just distributing that password out to the IB and Squad Alamo. We're starting to get them loaded in our other server there for their match. It's coming up in,
hey, they're in the cold,
30 minutes cold here, but I'm floating over storage right now.
Copy. And our next match is on Logar, correct?
Believe so. I'll have to double check.
I think it is.
Yes. Logar skirmisher. Yeah.
Another good match to cover from there, or map.
Yeah, man, it's been a while since I've covered Logar.
I know, all the new maps hit, and everyone kind of started playing them for a little bit. Logar kind of lost out on the rotation for a little while.
They're capping. It's
Logar, man, you're right.
All right, so what am I seeing here? I'm floating over storage. I'm seeing a lot
of HSG capped
mixed troops down here. Yeah, HSG and storage. Fubar kind of displaced out to those southeastern woods. Skirmishing with HSG. Fubar's out there in those woods. Skirmishing with HSG. Pretty disorganized at this point in the match.
HSG actually doing a good job of pushing that territory both on the east and west. They're managing to clear the contacts and get a solid foot.
Absolutely.
As you can see now, HSG really starting to sweep round to the south of storage just to try and clear all contacts that might be pushing in.
Fubar has a fob just north of Nilva. So that's definitely going to help them having that spawn support. However, you know, that also, on the flip side, that can also be a hindrance and a danger when it comes to them pushing south towards village, HSG. So it's kind of directly in that lane.
Through that. Yep.
That path of travel,
then,
you know.
Well, and then you talk about the ticket loss on the fob like that.
Mm-hmm. HSG actually going to find it very shortly. You've got,
Yeah, they're going to run out of the radius of it.
He's spotted all them coming in off it.
Yep.
Yeah, HSG now, we've got Spooky and Fisticuffs moving south.
They're going to run into a lot of HSG right there, though. I don't picture them moving in very far down there. But, like you said, they definitely probably know that FOB is down there.
Yeah, they'll have that intel of the spawn point and, you know, the push really doesn't matter. It's just the confirmation, really.
Enemies near the silo.
Yeah, that's a big threat to HSG. They're gonna focus a lot of manpower to kill that thing. I know we've said it before, and Bliss is Black Matt backed me up on this, but killing those fobs is important, if not more.
Yeah, definitely. It almost becomes your primary objective outside of the caps.
Absolutely.
We need to get out of here.
I'll spend more resources trying to kill the fob than it will actually defending the objective, because they know, you know, you take that fob down, they're not going to have anything nearby to, you know, to push that objective on you.
Yeah, right, and you're also that sort of, are they solely relying on that fob? And if that's the case, they're going to have to start spawning in for main, and that's a good old run.
Yeah, and that's really going to hinder them because they have no other fobs, and they're going to be able to steamroll them all the way to Nilrin.
Well, they definitely have now a clear grip on storage. It looks like HSG is out there in the west trying to find out if there's any more FUBAR running around out there. But clearly everyone now back towards Nilrim somewhat, or a little bit north of it.
Very interesting. I have a fob. Look at very far north. I'll let you guys discover it on your own. Open your maps.
Yep, I see it.
Yep.
Not sure what that's.
So how many people are they dedicating out there?
So there's three guys out there.
Is it three guys? Okay.
Yeah, that'll be the same three from FUBAR that were doing it in the first round.
Just to point out to this... Go ahead, sorry.
No, just saying skirting the map and getting them fobs up, which, works first round.
Thanks. Yeah, those guys up north. Yeah, I was going to point out to the stream, what I was talking about when I had them open their maps is India 2. Like literally outside of their main, they have a fob and a rally point. So
right,
They might drop. I'm willing to bet they're about to drop another fob out there right now in that northwest corner.
But one would argue that's completely irrelevant right now, having anything that far north when you could have those three guns down south.
And that's what you know when I play, and I'm sure you guys have dealt with this far more than I ever have, but. You know, you do a tactic like that if you knew you had the momentum that was going to get you there soon. You know what
Absolutely.
I mean? Like, if you felt it, that was a move that was plausible to pay off. But right now, FUBAR is just kind of on their heels in the back. You know, so I mean, that's three man of firepower that they're missing out on down here.
So right. Essentially, FUBAR are trying to plant 10 steps ahead.
Man, they Definitely. Just put up another fob there.
That's too much, I think.
Any potential fob spots you want?
They're planning 10 steps ahead, so putting fobs down for their cap in their second and first flag.
Yep.
Unfortunately, three guys in an 18-man team.
It's
a lot of people. Like,
also on a strategic standpoint, squads not that fixed. You don't want to have your tactics set fixed. I mean, if it works, I mean, I'll be surprised. I've never seen this before, so I can't really.
Well, but it goes back to like I said though, if you have the momentum and you think you're about to take storage, then you sit there and go, bam, that pays off. But they're not making a very good push right now into storage.
Absolutely.
Over HSG is just not giving up any territory.
Absolutely, and that's what I mean by having thinking too far ahead and having a fixed strategy like that. You know, you kind of be a little more flexible. You want more bodies down south, you know. Think about that next objective, or the second to last objective when you get to the next objective in front of you first.
Yeah, so I'd be sending them boys out when I'm 10% from neutral on storage. That's when I'd be sending them.
Right.
You know, but even before it's neutralized, I'd be getting it up, but not, you know, when you
when you're nowhere near
storage.
It. Yeah, and you're actually on your heels right now.
Again, I don't know if you want to take note of how spread FUBAR are. They're really just dotted around the map, and there's no real straight grouped up push.
Right.
Not hearing a lot of commander comms.
Yeah, no.
On this side either right now. Are you hearing much over there?
It's dropped down. It's dropped down this side as well.
I think after a while, as the commander comms lines, you end up sometimes where it's not that necessary.
They're pushing west. They're trying to.
Wow, there's a body that just flew up in the air like crazy.
I've seen that a couple times, a little bug.
I think from a HSG point of view right now is their game plan is pretty much fulfilled. They've capped storage, so now each squad's going to take up the role of who's going to push it, who's going to sit out, and who's going to sit on defense. And each squad is left to their own devices now without the commander comms.
If you guys are HSG, I mean... It doesn't seem like HSG is trying to penetrate Nilrim, except for that squad that's in the southwest. I don't know if they're slowly but surely trying to work their way in there, but there's not a very big push to get into Nilrim right now.
No.
I mean, is that the strategy of, hey, cap storage, hold storage, don't do anything else?
That's dependent on how the enemy's coming at you. That's kind of situation dependent.
I mean, that squad sort of out to the southwest, they're a six-man squad. So that's fine. I would send the six-man squad to start getting pressure on Nilrim. and I told the 6 and the 4 on storage, essentially.
Yeah, if you even need that much, I mean, you'll need to neutralize those enemy flags. You know, you as soon as you neutralize an enemy flag behind them, if you neutralize any of them right now, that's going to scare the crap out of HSG and, you know, HSG, I'm sorry, FUBAR, and they're going to...
FUBAR, yeah, they would all pull back.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, they'll take that pressure off of there, and then HSG can... It almost snowballs after that. If you get that, you get in their heads by neutralizing that point, they're going to freak out, and you can... You can sometimes snowball them. And you can visibly see that happen, too. Like, as soon as you neutralize something, all of a sudden the fire will actually kind of diminish off of you, and you can actually push in a little bit harder and get your momentum going.
So King of Canada and Endgame of FUBAR, I mean, they're definitely, it's one of those things where they're playing defensive Nilrim, but southwest of Nilrim, you know what I mean? They're up in those hills to prevent it, but notice HSG, Orange, and Jericho are trying to move a little bit east. They're about to come up the very southern flank of Nilrim right now.
Is Orange or Jericho a squad leader? Let's
say.
We have one person ahead.
Yep, one of them is.
Yes,
Orange.
Oranges, yeah.
What out?
Just a quick one, lads, for your information. I believe Hard HSG have found a spawn to the west of storage. Is that right?
No, I think so.
Yes.
Okay, yeah.
You see, well, I mean, you see the,
they have markers
the red
down.
Triangle.
It's that, yeah, that's FUBAR marking a possible fob. I think they're placing those down as build marks for them to build fobs,
gotcha.
I think. I think they're doing the opposite with it. That's why it's confusing me, too. They're doing that last round as well, too. Like, they placed one in the center of the map, and I was like, wait.
It's just there's a lot of chat on the HSG team about fobs and good movement, so...
Yeah, there's actually no fobs placed right now for FUBAR.
FUBAR
right
was
now.
Able to fend off that HSG attack in the southwest on Nilrim. Those guys are all down, so at least from that standpoint, they've kept those guys at bay right there.
We're at 238.
237.
Okay, we are 237. At 252.
252 to 237.
Too far off.
All right.
So FUBAR leading by 30 currently, is that right? What were you taking? It's 230.
36. 236.
Right, okay, yeah, so HSG in the lead. Sorry, my bad.
Well, so the HSG guys are back up in the southwest.
Good job.
So you've got Orange, Jericho, and 6.
Okay, so...
Endgame took one down.
HSG...
Endgame, Jericho's gonna... Go ahead, sorry.
Where are you at, Rusty?
I'm trying to get on the far side.
I'm floating over FUBAR... over here in the forest, and just east of storage.
Come down here for Nilrim. HSG is about to pull up on Nilrim, and get in there and start neutralizing it. You're definitely going to see a lot of FUBAR try to pull back.
FUBAR's, they're reacting right now. There's a small little four-man
squad.
Yeah, I see
Shaggy coming in, King of Canada, yep, they're coming in to take that.
Good reaction. Very good reaction from FUBAR on that.
Yeah, absolutely. And that, they realize they have tape deck left inside the objective zone to see if it were to start going down to call that out.
Sorry, lad. Just so HSG are all over their team chat saying it's gone too quiet, expect a large flank. And lo and behold, to the north, you've got 4 FUBAR that have managed to come around the north side. So HSG, straight onto that, just through the general feel of how the battle's going.
Yep, there they are, north of storage.
It's not going to be enough. I mean, personally, if I'm FUBAR now, I'd say regroup on Nilrim, make sure we hold it, because we're getting pressured. And then from that point, work your way out. Because they can't afford to have Nilrim capped. Like, Doc pointed
out. HSG has left just one person inside storage, and the rest are starting to pull down.
What are you saying, Blitha?
I was just saying, just like you pointed out, Doc, that FUBAR squad reacted very well and managed to clear both of them.
Yeah, it was nearly instantaneous. You could see it as soon as those rounds started popping off. I could see those 4 guys like a missile just coming straight for that tree line.
Yeah, yeah.
D7.
Oh, he's got 3 guys in Nilrim. It just slipped him in from the northeast.
HSG is pulling back to storage, part of them at least, knowing that those guys are there now.
Yeah, we'll see here now. Nilrim, just tape deck left. We'll see if he can relay this information that is being overrun to this FUBAR force up here to the southeast. Looks like they're coming down now to No room.
Can we get a
tape deck goes down.
There's a squad at the southwest of HSG down there. I don't know if they called it out. I couldn't hear it on the comms. But Fubar should be, you know, calling out those guys to the west southwest. Dude, there's definitely a five-door rally down there.
If HSG gets inside nil room and can hold off, I mean that's a everybody is now spawning on
down.
That fob.
Yep, it's about to go down.
There.
I'll hold it.
This is gonna be good.
Yeah, paddock stations for Fubar. That they see him rolling in.
That's where planting down where Skeletor's at right now. Planting down an AR or some type and start dumping rounds at that hillside as soon as they see those guys coming out.
Watch west.
They're heading down. Find that fob.
Their automatic riflemen are trying to pin those guys coming in. You know what I mean? Get a good base of fire.
Absolutely.
Suppress Fubar from coming in. But I'm just not even hearing the AR guy light up anywhere.
No, I'm not. Sorry, that's the same for all the support. I only heard one or two GLs go off, and really your GL should be going off constant. Like you said, AR rounds, you should be seeing tracers lighting up left and right. And it's
smoking them with the GLs too to mark the locations.
That's the hit I wanted to say too last round, man. You know, people are just too timid. You know, you got a whole squad pushing in like that. People will only fire half the time when they see something that they know there's an enemy there. You know, even if you don't see them, and you know those guys are coming from that direction, shoot in that direction.
You got ammunition
for a reason. Exactly. I know I've said it before in other streams. You know, playing support classes correctly, like Blitz said, you know, it's meant to dump rounds, not to be all stingy with your ammunition. You know?
That AR, you want to scare the shit out of people.
Yep, just dump rounds into them. That's the first thing I do. I would go cyclic with that thing.
I mean, I can imagine the squad leaders, as you and I would be, Doc, you know, screaming over the command, squad comms, stop pumping rounds into that hillside.
Yeah, absolutely.
Just whatever
you've got, stop
putting it in.
Yep. Fire your damn weapons. Shoot everything you have into those trees. Like, I don't care if you see anything or not. Just start firing.
Yeah, that's the thing. You don't have to see anything. You just start firing. It doesn't matter. Just, north, you know, you just say east. Fire. You know,
and that usually gets people pumped up, too. And they're like, oh, this is awesome. And then
I love nothing more than seeing the Grenadier finally dropping smokes on location. And then everyone just empties into that area. You know what I mean? You don't even know if you're hitting shit, but
wow, very good run.
It's one of those things.
Very good run there from Spooky. I was following him. He was just prone in the foliage there.
With all those bodies around him, yeah.
Yeah, and he was just taking names.
So this might be enough to reset the map a little bit. There's going to be a little skirmish going on up north on storage, but this big of a fight down here on Village is enough to kind of open Fubar's eyes a little bit to what's going on. So you're going to see a little bit of a reset of the map happen.
We only have two up right now inside Nilrim for HSG.
Almost fully covered.
And they're doing a pretty good job of those guys, but they definitely need some reinforcements to help them actually take that spot.
Yeah, you've got Skeletor and Six just off to the south. You've also got Jericho to the southeast, who's managing to keep Fubar pinned down then those poppies.
See, that's some of those times where, like, you wish, like, a guy like Jericho was the AR and just pummeling that field and those guys.
Yeah, absolutely. You'll notice anytime I play around, the first thing I'm yelling for in any kind of, like, contact is DLAR, grenades, AR, shoot everything. Like, it's the first thing. You want the most casualty inducing weapons to be firing on it, especially in an ambush situation. You know, you want that shock and awe. You get their heads down, they're going to think twice about moving any direction. And that gives you time to maneuver.
That's the thing with those poppies just out to the east of Nilrem as well. You shit your kecks coming down there anyway, whether, you know, there's contacts or not. If you start putting AR rounds down there, really, they do not want to put their heads above that ridge.
No, absolutely not. And if anything, they're going to focus on whoever's shooting that AR, so it kind of takes the attention off of whatever else is going on. Especially with public SLs you're going up against, because they sometimes can't quite... They'll get tunnel vision, and won't see everything for the bigger picture.
All right, WebMD trying to make a little push into Nilrim there. He just took down one of their guys.
So just a heads up, lads. HSG are now capping Nilrim.
Ooh.
Wow.
Which will not be happening anymore, as they've just dropped down to 2 in the cap zone.
193 tickets here for Fubar.
232 for HSG.
Okay. HSG starting to pull away again.
If you look up north just now, they're spawning more guys way up to the north. Judging what's happening down south right now, they really need to consolidate their efforts on the defense instead of worrying about what's going on the opposite end of the map. Q Because judging from how fast they're capping and how difficult it is to get in there, Fubar should just automatically assume that they're capping it, which they were.
And Fubar just spawned a whole lot of people up north, yeah.
Yeah, that's what I'm pointing out. Like, spawning anybody up that far north and thinking they're going to get down south in time, it's unrealistic.
Well, they seem to have gotten a... I mean, there's one guy running around Nilrim. You got Orange from HSG running in there, but it looks like they're about to get it back at least, or a better grip on it.
Right.
But well, HSG just had so many people close to storage that the likelihood of making a push on it with only, what do they got, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 guys, you know, against most of HSG's forces, I can't see them taking storage either.
The thing that you need to consider here, though, is that the squad that were attacking Nilrim for HSG have been wiped, essentially.
Right.
And they've got no spawn point. So...
This is one of the occasions, yeah.
Yeah, this is a scenario when you've got to read what's going on. So, they've been wiped. Squad 1 have tried pushing out west for a fob, essentially leaving the west side of storage open. Sometimes it's luck, sometimes you know what you're doing, but Fubar really needs to start pushing in now, and they'll be able to start neutralizing storage.
Right.
It seems
really
they're trying.
That west.
Now, still, look in the far west. Same. HSG seems to be doing a pretty big flank maneuver.
So that was that fob that's just gone up.
Okay. Yeah.
Squad 2 have just spawned in.
Okay. It's a very odd ebb and flow of these two teams here.
Yeah.
It's a little bit different to.
HSG certainly seems like they're that force is out in the west. Looks like a big collection, and they're spacing out. That they're going to try to come hit Nilrim hard.
Right.
I think
there's only two guys left back at storage that you hope can pin off those other guys.
Just going back to what you're saying, Doc, about a very strange like feel of the game and the way it's played out. I just think
you're
that's
getting
what
that too?
Yeah, definitely. But I think I've noticed it when you're up against a very well matched clan or team.
Yeah.
Things are just happening, and you can't, you know, your logic's out the window a little bit, and your normal practices are gone. I think that's what's just happening now. Teams are just trying to come up with something different, and it's just throwing the weight of the game off a little bit.
Yeah, absolutely. That's what I'm saying. They massed. I was saying Fubar coming from up north to come down south to help defend, and they end up killing that fob down south on Nilrim, and are kind of breaking out a little bit. So
HSG, that big force up because of some attacks going on at storage.
Fubar about to hit storage from the north. I mean, sometimes all it takes is one or two guys to spook HSG, especially with the amount of guys they have on storage right now. They take a little contact. Think that there's more coming from the north or wherever than they anticipate. So they might break off some of those guys attacking to come help storage, which is going to change the rest of the ebb and flow of that attack that HSG was trying to take in. Which looks like is happening.
Just another heads up, lads. Fubar have found HSG's fob that they've just put out to the west.
Yeah, no, it's Bravo 9 Clear. I was over there. Yeah, let's go Ball City.
You know, it's funny about that. The guy that found it out there is their medic.
I just got taken down here.
You know, and you just sit. Man, medics are so important to be so close to the other squad members, you know?
Aye.
Absolutely.
They have something done. So, fob on you, Joe.
So, Fubar's inside storage right now, and they're about to get more people inside storage.
So, I have.
They're about to get a lot of people inside storage here in a second.
Fubar's got fob marks on Alpha 7 Key 6.
Yep.
Is that an accurate one?
Yeah, so Justice was actually camping it. He has been taken out, though.
Okay.
But they know it's there. I think Harlstars has now taken it up.
Looks like all of HSG pretty much just spawned on that fob out there. I guarantee you they're all going to start funneling into storage right now.
Yeah, Fubar will be neutralizing that cap due to the numbers they've got there.
Well, make a push.
If it works, think about their fobs up there in the far north. If they get that, you know what I mean? That's a quick sprint over to Castle at that point.
True, but they also have what's left over of whatever HSG's down south to contend with as well. Because that's a measurable thing. Capping a flag ahead, you're going to get that reverb, I guess you could say, that bounces off the old flag that comes back to try and recap the old objective.
Yeah. They've got 6 people. Oh, 5. 1 just went down. HSG's coming in hard from the west on storage.
Very hard.
Yeah, they've practically cleared the east side as well. So,
Tanner, did you go down too?
That's a safe situation.
Yeah, they're on the west
east versus west right now.
Tell just.
Two-bar majority down. There's one guy up end game and Sunny on the west side.
You're right.
He's not in my squad.
They're all likely. They're gonna have to spawn at that fob in the far north, or they're gonna have to spawn at main. If most of them are down.
We're at 177.
211 for HSG.
HSG pulled away a little bit. Very interesting round.
Both teams really strong on flanks for both matches.
There's two levels, you know. Flanking's awesome, you know. Flanking will get the job done, but there's two different levels to any kind of game plan. You've got tactical levels, you know, the small unit tactics, and you've got strategic levels, you know, moving those squads around to implement those tactics.
Mm-hmm.
You know, those wide flanks with the squad, you know, it's a good strategy. You know, however, that strategy might not pay off when you don't have those tactics there for that squad to implement.
Yeah, you've got to back it up.
Right, laying down a blaze of fire and attacking. And same thing goes with attacking and defending objectives. Especially defending, you know, putting down a base of fire, keeping enemy away from you, all the jazz. So it comes down to communication and then the ability for those clans and those teams and those small squads to implement those tactics. So you can have somebody that's, you know, they go wide, but when it comes to it, they all just kind of run at them, you know, Civil War style, or, you know, running at them with, like, muskets. Like,
yeah, as you said, you know, if you spend 5 minutes taking a flank, six guys, you got to make sure the rest of your team's there to back you up. So
right.
You don't get wiped, and that's a waste of time.
Right. And then that even goes even smaller, right? And then you can go pretty deep with this. It goes even smaller. It comes down to the player knowing the class that they have. You know, AR, dumping rounds, Grenadier, dumping grenades.
We should capture all three flags, gain 30 tickets.
Medic doing their jobs. So there's definitely layers of play that, you know, these teams have to take into account when trying to take anything. And that's the meta with squad that people don't realize.
Definitely.
So much deeper than a lot of people, you know, people notice.
Now it's only going to get deeper and deeper, too.
Yeah, I love it. That's my favorite part.
Yeah, we got a long way to go.
I can speak on that for, like, logistics as far as these random fobs out in the middle of nowhere. Fob flexibility is going to go down when you start delivering supplies in order to build fobs or however they end up doing it. Ooh, putting almost ran into my buddy's grenade.
Seems like everyone's back to hovering mostly around storage again.
Yeah.
Everyone abandoning Nilrim.
Yeah. Good.
I just say both clans again, very spread out. The lines are so intertwined. There's no real front line for either clan, and you're just wondering how much of a disadvantage that is hampering essentially FUBAR in this round, because they're the ones having to take it by the scruff of the neck and really push for the win.
It looks like FUBAR's all along that line on the east, a little bit north and south of it, but I don't know if they're trying to fight their way to clamp down on it, but, you know, HSG has feelers out there in those woods that are kind of preventing that total push.
Yeah, and the thing is, there's too much space in between the little groups, so essentially HSG can just slip through and disrupt.
He was hurt. Yep.
Yeah, there's definitely blind spots in the lines for FUBAR. Obviously, it's quite easy to see from opposition now, but you're on the deck. It's a little bit harder to manage.
Gonna spoke to Body just in time. Yeah, it was just one guy I saw.
Evade.
199 tickets here for HSG.
153.
Rusty, were we going to mention giving away a squad key after
maybe
this?
Gonna be attacking
well, after we're going to go after the second match, correct? IB and Squad
okay.
Alamo.
I didn't know if we're going to do one after this one and then one after the other.
No, those guys are.
We got to roll into it,
yeah,
right?
They're sitting there rolling in our second server there, getting ready to go.
Can we mark Bob again?
Back.
HSG has a clear run into Nilrim right now.
not quite sure where it was.
You have a couple guys. I don't know if they're about to go try to drop a fob right quick. I don't know if you see them. Nope, a couple of them are running down into Nilrim now. You guys picking up on that?
Yeah, I'm just over there.
Yeah, as well.
You got Spooky and No.
Fisticuffs coming from the east.
Yeah, Fisticuffs coming from the east. They're going for that. Now neutralize again.
Wow, Fubar's. Some of them are running back now.
They might have noticed it. I think somebody spotted Fisticuff.
That's
maybe not.
Not. Dogfish is running back.
Oh, sneaky.
Wow.
Sneaky.
Yep.
Game changer right there.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know where Kev ran off to on HSG. That would have been more body getting in there. I don't know if he's out there fob hunting, though.
Fubar just had someone spawn at main. We might have eyes on them.
Yep, two of them. Gonzo and Stealth.
Yeah, they do have three of them, so you've got Spooky, No, and Fisticuff all prone, trying to hide out. Let's see if they get it neutralized at least.
The trick is stay low, get in cover. As soon as they pass into that cap zone, it gets evened out. You just got to.
They're about to get discovered. Fubar's coming in.
Why does HSG keep talking on all comms?
I don't know.
I'm hearing anything from HSG.
They're capping Nilrim, but we're capping it back now. We have more help.
They just, Commander Comm just said they're capping Nilrim, but we're capping it back. We have more people. So.
Yep. That comes down to. Now we can be.
Oh!
Yep, there they go.
Oh, ouch. Big rocket from Fisticuffs.
No, we just got atomized.
All right, they got one of the HSG guys in there. No went down.
Watch out that west side. My body, top deck's body.
So he's kind of puckering right now. He's waiting.
Yep, see if he gets Gonzo right there. Markers.
Stealth coming up on his right.
Yeah, he stays down right now. Doesn't move. Oh, Stealth's going to kill him. All he needed was that shot right there to hear where he's at.
They don't even see each other right there.
Spooky might hear his footsteps, though. Oh, God.
Yeah. Oh man! I thought Spooky was gonna have that. He fired first. I thought.
Wasn't quite spooky enough.
Spooky
that's
and
the
stealth.
Beauty of this game. Stuff like that really is.
Spooky and stealth.
Gold.
Oh, stealth goes down.
Oh.
Wow.
Oh, with a TK.
Was that friendly? Yeah, I was gonna say friendly fire right there.
That's the beauty of this game, you get situations like that, 2 feet away from each other.
Imagine once they add the bending of the vegetation too in those fields.
Oof.
Oh yeah, definitely.
You mean like raptors moving through the tall grass in like Jurassic Park.
Well, if you go back out to storage now, Ubar really spaced out again. I don't know if they're trying to come back down on storage or what. Really spaced out.
Just drip feeding. One or two at a time. It's a look at HSG. Look at him. Straight on.
This is where, you know, the constant push from Fubar, you know, it's clearly not working for him to keep pushing from the north like that. And this is where you kind of adjust your tactics, adjust your strategy here. And you just keep throwing people at him. There's a certain point where you got to kind of stop, take a step back, and think, like, okay, am I just feeding them tickets? Or, you know, should I come at this from a different angle? Try something new. And I think Fubar's at that point, if not past it already. They might have passed it a while ago. 29 tickets.
HSG's got three people right back in Nilrim again.
Drop a flash.
Obviously. Yeah, it looks like they've cleared Fubar within the cap zone.
Also, too, it's worthy to note that they're moving out now, but HSG had two guys in the castle. Just in case.
So we're at 190 tickets for HSG.
128.
Drop that flash fob if possible. Only got one guy on me right now.
No, my guy spawned at main. Oh my god. No.
Alright, Fisticuff spawned, and they must have a rally over there, but they're Fisticuff and Spooky trying to get back into Nilrim. Some good grenades coming in by No. He just took out Justice from Fubar down in Nilrim. So there's not a single Fubar guy up in Nilrim right now.
Everyone get on village. Don't want to lose that board. Drop a
well, I have noticed about HSGs, make a lot of use of the actual text chat. So, you know, it's not just across the squad leaders, it's between squad, you know, squad members. So essentially, they're calling out where people are relative to the map by name as well, which is quite impressive.
Right, that's where that commander comms can sometimes be limiting if you're not disseminating that information to the entire team. You might say something on commander comms that needs to be on all comms.
To village,
yeah. And you'll get people in your squad or, you know, tell Hardstyles that Axel's got contacts on him.
Where my body is.
You know, to try and get that conveyed between two people and then a third, time-consuming ways, they can just type it, and that seems to be working for HSG at the minute.
HSG and Nilrim got four up. They're nicely spaced out, but boy, there's a lot of food bar about to come in on it from all
tickets.
Angles. Yep.
Neutralizing this flag.
Rusty, where are you covering?
I'm right over Nilrim right now.
Okay.
I think having those fobs spaced out up north for Fubar, I think is... They're kind of coming at them half and half from the north and south every time. So I think eliminating that and not thinking quite so far ahead and pushing with a big solid front from the north, from the south, and being able to maneuver a little bit more, have more options like that, I think. I don't know, Blitz, I don't know what you think about that.
Definitely, I'm very much a supporter of using your full team to its full capabilities,
right.
And that is
right.
As a unit. There are times when you need to separate. This is not one of them. When you've got to make a real strong push for a flag, you need to get everyone central, get them together,
right.
And move as a unit.
Absolutely, that's what
Fubar
I'm thinking.
Fubar, stop that.
Placing those fobs up north like that, being that far ahead is just too much. You're hindering yourself.
So HSG did fend off Nilrim. No one else is up from HSG there.
10 tickets left.
Yep.
181 here. So 70 ticket difference.
Hey, we got contact at the fob north this one.
So, HSG with the lock on storage.
Like to remind everybody too, coming up after this match, we're gonna roll very shortly into Clan IB versus Squad Alamo, taking place on Logar.
That's gonna be really interesting.
Yeah, the Logar skirmish with these numbers is pretty damn good.
Yeah, one Logar, two Alamo. Never seen those guys play yet, so.
We haven't either. This will be their squad league cherry. .108 here.
There's nothing else like it. They'll see. You win or lose, like it's something. It's something different in a squad league match. But you and I can. You can kind of comment on that too as well. It's totally different from a pub match, man.
I feel very strongly about that.
It's a lot more intense.
And especially for Fubar, this is, you know, their first covered game officially about them, you know, essentially them versus HSG. So these boys are going to take a lot from it. They're going to watch this great stream back and improve.
Mr. Shaggy, you know, is clan lead. They're definitely dedicated to getting better, you know, trying to watch these footages, find out what they can do to improve, you know. In the future, I'm going to talk about a future thing real quick. The battle recorder will be fixed. And, you know, we'll be able to provide all the clans these files from these matches so that they can watch and really find out what they've been doing and what they might need to do to improve.
5 tickets left here.
I hope I can scrape a few kills in these last few minutes.
You know, both of these clans are relatively new. Fubar have exploded on the scene, essentially, with a lot of members. HSG also. Slightly different recruitment policy. They're very... very selective in the choices. Fubar, like I said, have exploded with a lot of people wanting to join them. So both clans got a great future in front of them. This is just a start.
two tickets left here.
So it's going to call it automatically, correct, Rusty?
I believe so, unless IBK is calling it.
Fumar.
Yeah.
Oh.
Over and over, real quick, listen to the music.
Yeah.
Good music.
Oh, man.
Where at?
He's playing.
Right over Nilrim.
Yeah, he's about two tickets.
He's going to be very happy that I caught that on stream.
Gotta love these clients, though. That just that alone right there. No, nobody gets like sour and bitter.
Yep.
Yeah, and you know, we spoke about it last week. Every clan's starting to grow their own personality now. It's brilliant.
Yeah, oh yeah.
And that's 100. So there we go. That is going to be match. Let's go ahead and call that. Again, 169.
Yeah, make sure to screenshot it.
Wow.
69 twice.
Interesting.
Wow.
69 tickets again.
Kills were exactly the same. It's just.
What are the odds?
No.
What
are
the odds? Never
expected.
Yeah,
same
yeah, what were you thinking odds. About being the same there?
Yeah. Sorry,
lads. Don't jinx it.
That was my bad. Sorry, lads.
All right. Well, so that's going to do it for HSG versus Fubar. So HSG moves on in the bracket. Fubar is eliminated. And now we're going to go get ready for our second match of the day. We still got two more rounds to be played. We're going to go over to Logar in about 5-10 minutes here. We're going to take a little break, and we'll be following Squad Alamo as they face off against... Who are they playing?
IB.
IB, that's right. Jeez. All right, so IB versus Squad Alamo. Coming to you shortly, we're going to get those guys ready to go, and we will see you guys in just about 10 minutes here.